you're new here, my name is Yasi and I'm a Master of Health Administration student at Columbia University. I know a lot of you first started following me because of my decision reaction video when I first got in exactly a year ago yesterday, January 29, 2019. So I kind of wanted to make a recap video now that my first semester was over and answer some of your questions. I get a lot of people that message me on Instagram, LinkedIn, and everything in between, just wanting to know more about Columbia, the program, how to get into an Ivy League, and I kind of just wanted to make this video and address some of those questions in case others were curious about the same thing. So just to get started, I am doing a Master of Health Administration. So if you're not familiar, because I know I wasn't before I started the program, it's like a combination of an MBA and an MPH. So it's like you're studying public health, but in regard to the business side of things. And at Columbia, that is a two-year program, and cost of attendance per year is like altogether about $80,000, which is a lot of money, I know. And you know, that's obviously including tuition, but also cost of attendance, books, transportation. New York in general is just really expensive, and I know before I came here I was really going back and forth about the cost. So at the end of the video I'll do like a was this worth it type of thing. And again, like, this was only after my first semester. I'm hoping I could do another recap for you after my first year, and then after the program is done altogether, and I'm really curious how my answer might change throughout this time. MHA cohort is about 50 students, which is more than most graduate programs I've heard, but the Masters of Public Health program that Columbia has is about 450 students, because there's a lot of smaller programs within that one MPH school. My program specifically, I think about half of us came with having work experience and half of the students came straight from undergrad. So if you're still in college while watching this, don't stress out. I thought everybody went to get a master's program after working some years, but that doesn't seem to be the case. So you don't necessarily need to have work experience while you're applying or before you start. And I know for my program, we have a good amount of international students, which is really exciting. The cohort overall isn't as diverse as I thought it would be, to be honest. I think public health draws people from all backgrounds, but an MHA kind of tends to draw people that are into more of the business side, which honestly I am not at, but that's a whole different story. But anyways, business in general doesn't seem to always be as diverse, and I think that's also reflected in my professors. Most of my professors were cis white men, and I just want to put that out there in case anybody... I know for my undergrad I didn't have diverse professors, and I really wanted to have professors that look like me or reflect my experiences during grad school, and I will admit I was slightly disappointed that that hasn't been the case. But the professors here are still incredible and come with a lot of great life experience. For the first semester, we are recommended not to work. As you might have seen in the last couple of videos I made, obviously that just wasn't feasible for me given how expensive Columbia is. So I started working the first week of school and I've been working since, but most of my peers haven't. And I think obviously working takes away from time that you would do going to office hours, studying, study groups, getting to just work on assignments overall. So I do think that might have negatively impacted my grades last semester, but honestly I would rather get to practice my time management skills and prioritizing my workloads and financially being independent and paying for school on my own than just focus on doing well in school. But that's just how I've always been. I worked since I was in high school, I worked all of undergrad. So if that is a worry for you, if you always worked, I think it's feasible to work while going to school, but just keep in mind that in a way you're being compared to students who aren't working, and that's just something to keep in mind. My program specifically, which has been slightly unique than my undergrad experience, for my undergrad I was like pre-med, and I think all the students were really kind of put up against each other as competition because everything was on a curve and you kind of needed other people to do poorly so you could do better. And some of our classes here are also on a curve, but I think on like a larger scale, the program is very collaborative. I think we all try to help each other out as much as we can, and like whether that's helping each other with homeworks, the exams. For example, I know for me specifically, last semester for our final we had an economic study guide, so like I did the study guide and I shared it with my classmates because at the end of the day, like, I just want everybody to succeed, and I think that's how everybody feels. Like at the end of this, we're all gonna get jobs. You don't need other people to do bad so you could do better. So I really like that it's very collaborative and everyone just wants each other to succeed. I will admit the program feels slightly cliquey, and I think like that happened pretty early on. I've always been more of a loner, keep to myself type of person, so like I'm more of like the observer from an outsider perspective, but I can tell that like most of the program has formed little groups, and again, there's nothing wrong with that. And that could just be with my program. That doesn't mean like all years, all grad school programs are gonna be like this. I just wanna tell you all about my experience because a lot of you ask. As far as classes, first semester we had 6 classes. Second semester is a lot more dense, and each class that we have is 3 hours long. And that was really new to me because during my undergrad, my lectures were 2 hour max, but usually around 1. But here we only meet once a week, but classes are 3 hours, and that could take a lot of adjusting to, because like this semester Mondays we had 8 hours of classes, but on average it's about 6, and then usually there's info sessions or like different group meetings in between, so it could end up being really long days. And I decided to live on campus because I moved. Like, I worked up until Friday, I moved here Saturday night, and school started on Monday. So I didn't have time to come to New York and New York like apartment hunt, which is a beast in and of itself if any of you are considering that. So I'm really happy living on campus because it makes like going to class a lot more convenient, especially during the days that we have like weird breaks. Or the 8 a.m.s that we have, like New York transportation is a mess, and sometimes for an 8 a.m. that means you have to wake up at like 5 or 6 to leave your house by 7 the latest, because there's always delays and professors get really frustrated when you come to class late. So that's just something to keep in mind if you're thinking about coming to a Maryland School of Public Health specifically. If you have the option of living on campus, that might be something to think about. I only address that because again, I never saw anybody talking about that, and I just want all of you to have all the information you need. Some things that I wasn't expecting that have caught me off guard was, again, that a lot of our professors are cis white men, and that the program has been really business focused. I guess like I kind of knew, but I didn't realize how much. I wanted to do a Master's of Health Administration instead of a Master's of Public Health because I like money makes me really uncomfortable, and I don't really like the business side of things, but I love public health because I want to make healthcare more accessible. But I know to get to the roles where people are making decisions that are affecting everybody's health, you need to have those administrative business skills. So I purposely wanted to be a little bit uncomfortable in getting a Master's of Health Administration. And I will say there's a lot of business classes, and there's a lot of quantitative skills that you need to learn that have been challenging for me personally because it just requires you to think differently. Another weird thing was that we didn't get to register for any of our own classes. The whole cohort takes every class pretty much together, and they're all registered for us ahead of time. So that's just also something to keep in mind. Like, you aren't allowed flexibility within your schedule. You kind of just get whatever is assigned to you. One exciting thing is that we never have any classes on Fridays, which is really nice because I end up working all day Fridays, and it's nice to just be focusing on that one thing versus most of the other week of going to class, then running to work and going to class, and then doing homework at night. So having Fridays off allows a lot of flexibility with your schedule if you want to do other things, and for me that's just been working. Big question is going to an Ivy League hard, or is getting a Massive Health Administration hard, or is doing a Massive Health Administration at Columbia hard? And my honest answer is that my undergrad was so hard, like being pre-med was so hard, that I think anything compared to that would be easier. So I've been a little bit surprised by how much easier this has felt. I don't know if I just never, like maybe I just never belonged in that program, but I was too stubborn to let it go during undergrad, and now I'm in a program that better fits me and what I want to do, so it feels more exciting and approachable. But to me, grad school has been easier than my undergrad was. I think it, especially if you're not working, the workload is really manageable, but if you are working and going to school, obviously makes it a lot harder because you have to split your time. Another thing to keep in mind, this didn't really affect me because I had grown up in New York before I moved to Oregon. So coming back to New York for grad school was kind of like returning to home, and I didn't go through a settlement period at all. Like, I moved here, school started, and I kind of hit the floor running. But I know for some of my peers, being in New York has been hard, especially if this is the first time you're moving away from your family. And I know that that part was hard for me because I've always lived in the same state as my family, even though I went away for college. So being across the country with a 3-hour time difference definitely makes an impact on like everything. Like, I just don't get to FaceTime my parents. Like, when my parents are getting off of work, I'm like ready to go to bed, you know, and when I have time, they don't. So it's like conflicting schedule times, and like that obviously plays a role with like friendships, relationships. If you're moving across the country or anywhere that's far enough to have a time zone, but also even if you're within the same time zone, I think just like moving away from home and everything you know and everything that feels comfortable could be challenging. That's just something to keep in mind. I think New York specifically could be overwhelming for a lot of people because it's really fast paced. Everyone's hustling all the time, and I love that because I feed off that energy. And being in Oregon, it felt like everything was too slow because I was always like trying to grind, and I was like the odd one out. But here it's like everyone's doing that, so it's just a different pace of life. So just keep that in mind if you're not used to that. There's something going on at all times, which I love. Like, you could do anything at any point in the day and you'll never get bored. But for some people, that could be overwhelming. So if it's your first time moving to New York, I think New York gets really romanticized in the movies and TV shows. And living here is definitely a lot different of experience than when you're visiting or when you're just hearing about it or seeing about it in the movies. So just mentally prepare yourself if you're thinking about coming here. And I made it to the last part of the video. Is going to an Ivy League worth it? Honestly, for me, I got a scholarship covering half of tuition, and that made the world of the difference. That lifted the weight of the world off of my shoulders, because trying to pay for that, like even with student loans, like I've definitely taken a lot of student loans and I stress about that constantly. I just keep trying to tell myself that it'll all be worth it one day. I can't say for sure right now if that's right, but I'm gonna manifest that I'll just get a high enough paying job afterwards that it'll balance out the fact that I had to take out so much student loans. So I would say it's worth coming here if you get some kind of scholarship. But if you have options between Columbia and other schools, and Columbia seems like the most expensive, maybe consider some of the other schools, because I think at the end of the day, education wise we're all getting the same level of learning. Honestly, like I can't say because I can only attest to what I'm learning, but public health is public health, and like business skills and quantitative skills and economics and accounting like don't change. So I think obviously for Columbia you're paying for the name, and in my personal experience, like obviously people will treat you different when you say you're from Columbia, and I personally don't like that. Like I think a lot of my peers are like, oh, you go to Columbia, and I'm like, I don't know how I got here. Like, I'm normal, I'm really not that smart, I'm like mediocre at best. Obviously when employers look at you like, oh, you went to Columbia, it's like, yeah, I went to Columbia, but like they could look at me differently. I don't like it when like my peers look at me differently, because like nobody that goes to an Ivy League is any different. Like, it just means, I just feel like if you go to an Ivy League, what it means is that you either had a rich parent that was willing to pay for you, or you were like me and you were stupid enough to take out the student loans to pay for it, or you were like absolutely brilliant and you got a full ride. But I am not in that boat, so I can't speak about like the experiences of those people. I just know for me it's really expensive, but so far I just love being back in New York, and I love what I've been learning, minus the business skills. I haven't really loved those, but I think Columbia focuses a lot on professional development, and I didn't have that during undergrad, so it's been like a breath of fresh air, and I've been really happy to be able to pay that on by offering to review people's resumes for free. So if you follow me on Instagram or LinkedIn, you've already seen that. If you haven't, message me on LinkedIn and I will send you my personal email, and I'll be happy to look over your resume for free, of course. But yeah, short answer, yes, as of right now I think it's worth it, but only if you get a scholarship covering at least some portion of the cost of living, because it's ridiculously expensive. But yeah, that brings us to the end of the video. I hope that answered your questions. If you have any more questions, please feel free to leave it down in the comments. And thank you for watching this video, and I'm excited to see you back here again.